Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be painting a shamrock, so let's do it. Okay, so in honor of St. Patrick's Day, I'm going to show you guys a really simple way to make a shamrock. I just kind of figure in every painting that we do for St. Patrick's Day, you're going to need a shamrock, so we might as well teach you how to make it, all right? So this is a simple way to do it. You do not need to go, let me show you and then I'll explain more about it, okay? So basically, here are the materials for today. Number one, the paint, I'm using acrylic paint. These are Blick paint acrylics. I'm using phthalo green, chrome yellow, and white. You do not need to use Blick acrylics in order to do what I'm doing today. That's what I use and I thought I would tell them. Any like classic green and yellow white will work perfectly. This is a mixed media pad. It's a close to an 8x10. It's a little bit smaller than that. Feel free to do this on an 8x10 canvas. Sometimes I love working on wood panels, also really great. I'm gonna be creating like a little stencil for myself, and I'm doing that just with paper. This is just like computer paper. I cut out a small piece and you wanna bend it in half, and I'll show you the trick. Then we have a pencil, any pencil. This is a Princeton size 4 brush. My favorite brushes are either a size 4 or 6 from Princeton. They're both fantastic. Paper towel for wiping your paintbrush on, and then scissors because we're going to be cutting out a stencil. So let's begin. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece of paper and I'm going to just make a heart. Okay. So to make a heart, think of it like a candy cane. We're making half a heart, I should say, because the whole heart will come when we cut this out. All right. So I'm going to cut this out. I'm going to make this like a candy cane. Do not worry about this looking perfect by any means. You guys know I love to refer to the paint bar inch, which is like if you take your pinky from knuckle to knuckle, that's about an inch. So this one is like a little bit less than an inch, a little bit less than 2 inches, so about an inch and a half or so. All right, and that works really well on this size canvas or paper, like an 8x10. So if you're working with something smaller, you do want to reduce the distance between the top and the bottom of the heart. So let's cut it out. And also keep in mind that you do not need to cut it out exactly. If it's a little bit bigger or smaller, that's okay. All right. So here, I'm cutting it out a little bigger, not intentionally, just because. So first of all, this is beautiful. There you go. You can have a little like card for yourself, a little pop-up card. But we're just making a little stencil like this, okay? So what's really fun about a shamrock is that it's actually made out of three of these. So let's start like this. So generally in my classes, you guys know I never trace anything with a pencil. I always go right on it with paint. But with this, I'm gonna, just cause it's a quick tutorial, I thought it might be easiest to do with a pencil. So take the pencil, go around your heart. Okay, so that's the first one. So this is gonna be the center right here. Okay, now also the center is a little bit above the center of my whole space because we do have a stem. Okay, so if you were to make this center right in the middle of your whole paper, then the stem may come down a little bit lower than you'd like. So just a little thing to think about. Now I'm gonna line up the point of the heart with that circle. Again, it's gonna be facing out to like 12 o'clock. I'm sorry, this is 9 o'clock. This is 12, we're going out to like 9 o'clock. If you were to have it touch, which you could, then you're gonna get like one more solid shape. I wanna have a little bit of breathing room. So I'm gonna leave a little bit of space in between here and here. And when we start painting, you're gonna see it kinda gets filled in anyway. So let's do this and come on the other side like that, okay? And then we're gonna do one more over here on the right. Like that. All right, now, the next thing we're gonna do is, we can just put that to the side, you're done with it? Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make the base. I'm just gonna have you guys come down like a little line right from the center, and I have it curved just a little bit, so it goes out to the left slightly. It's about 2 to 2.5 inches in length. I'm gonna give it a tiny little line at the bottom, and I'm gonna then, from here, this is like a quarter of an inch, not even, and then I'm gonna have it go from the bottom and just come out. Okay, now this line, I've done this paint, I've now created one of these for a tutorial a few times, and it tends to just get really thick really fast, so keep that in mind. All right, so we're done with the pencil, and we are done with your scissors. So next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna use this brush. I'm gonna give it a little dunk in my water, tap it off a few times and wipe it on my paper towel. And then we're going to create almost like the perfect St. Patrick's Day green. So I never like to use a green or any color right out of the bottle. I always like to mix it up a little bit with other colors. So for this one, I'm actually going to take, surprisingly, I know this is a green, everything about St. Patrick's Day is green, but we're actually going to mix this paint into your yellow. And I'm not going to fully mix it. I like to just do a little mixing, throw in a little bit of the white as well. I like to do the majority of the mixing on the actual paper, canvas, whatever you're painting on. All right, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come down, I'm just gonna paint around my space. I like to create like a little outline for myself, like that. All right, so I'm gonna do that on all of them. And don't worry too much about what this color is right now. You can always come back and perfect it. We're just kind of creating a base color. All right, and then I'm gonna have you guys come down. If you want to, you could even use a smaller brush to do the stem. So I should have said that at the beginning. If you wanted to, you could use like a size 1 or 2 to do your stem, and that might help prevent it from getting too thick at the bottom, which was my issue, as I mentioned a few times. So you wanna paint right over your pencil. Okay, now let's go back to that bigger brush. So I want to use this as a size 4 Princeton brush, and I am going to fill in the whole thing. I'm going to use more of my green, some yellow, a little bit of the white, and I'm just going to go right in there. I'm not going to think about what colors look like, what my brush stroke looks like. I just want to get the whole thing covered. All right, so there's one. There's another one. Let's do a little bit of green, some yellow, and a little bit of the white. So I'm kind of creating like a pretty good base coat. And when you go around the edges, I always get a little bit, I kind of slow down just a little bit so I make sure that I have a nice edge. Like that. And then let's come back. So now you could be done, right? You can be done. This is your shamrock. That's the basic way to make it. But I always like mine to have a little bit more going on. So I don't want it to look, this looks like one kind of green. So now that I've made my base layer, I'm going to go back in doing what we call kind of like a plop and pull, going around the outer edge with my darker green. And I do that because it just brings your eye in a little bit. So I'm going to do like a little highlight with the dark green just around the outer edges. I did not wash my brush off. Let's do a little bit more on the bottom here. All right, I'm gonna do a little bit more of the yellow, a little bit more white. So notice how I'm just going right back on top. You don't have to worry about color showing through because we had that base color. So now by just kind of circling a little bit, you know, not circling, but adding these lines right on top, filling it in a little bit, I'm just making it a little bit more interesting, right? And I keep moving in that heart shape. So, you know, it just, your eye keeps traveling around. I'm gonna do a little bit more of the dark green again up top here, maybe a little bit more here. So it's all about the layers. And there we go. All right, now you can keep going at it forever, but at some point you gotta stop. All right, and I'm gonna go back onto the stem as well using the same baby little tiny brush about a size. This is a size 1. So usually when I'm using my round brush, I recommend a size 4 or a size 6, and then I recommend a size 1 or 2 for your tiny detail brush. And sometimes it's nice to actually have both and then you have the option. So I'm going into this one with a little bit more of the dark green. Like that. Bring on a little bit of the yellow, a little bit of the white. And there you go. Thank you all so much for watching my video. I hope you liked it. I hope you learned something. Now don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also follow us on Facebook and Instagram to learn more tips and tricks and see more painting tutorials. And lastly, if you want to reach me directly, you can always text me. This is directly to me, 617-553-6778. I'd love to hear from you. Again, 617-553-6778. Can't wait to paint with you again soon. Have a great day. Bye.